The word mask to me means the opportunity to explore or the opportunity to express. I know in my personal experiences when wearing a mask, I've felt more myself than I have without it. I feel more comfortable, I feel more liberated, I feel connected into my body in a way that I don't if I'm more conscious of my face.
My name is Katie Green and I'm a visual artist here in Calgary, and I'm going to be doing the next installation for the East Village Riverwalk public art installation called Bridge. My incentive for wanting to apply for this project was to think about how to sort of bridge the gaps between these different community groups or have a piece of public work that could help facilitate conversation and connection. I'm working with the local social worker for East Village, Calgary Family Services, and then all of the new residents, you know, in the new buildings, and then all of the older residents in the older developments. So a lot of those developments are, they're low-income housing. So a lot of seniors live in these buildings. So I'm trying to sort of facilitate and connect with all these different groups. You know, as I take into consideration what connection means, I think I'm just trying to approach this really authentically and honestly, really actively listen to these different individuals in terms of why this project could be interesting to them, how it could benefit them, because everyone will have a different, you know, a different approach.
So couture.
Oh, I love it.
Because of what you actually shared in your journaling about like that icy feel, mm-hmm. that yeah. kind of cold feel, and I think this is a big reason why we chose like this gray and this concrete.
Yeah. It's really rooted in the process. So yes, there will be a final image that will be the final result of this artwork, which will be a photograph of each participant in their mask. But I think that the biggest thing is the process of how that person made that mask, how that object can stand in for a tool for that person to share a bit of themselves. There will be three workshops in May, and the first workshop will be an opportunity for all the participants to meet one another, share a conversation with each other, and then pick an image to create a mask from. And that image is based off of the technique that I have done to create my masks. So all of those little portraits, I'm gonna be bringing about 50 of them in, and each participant will have the opportunity to look at those portraits and choose one that resonates with them. And then that portrait will start conversation in terms of why do you want to embody that character? What does that character say about who you are? And that portrait, like the same way I've done my mask in the past, will become a mask.
Some of the stuff that's coming up is like about what the mask means to them individually, about the different masks that we wear. Some people are sharing pretty specific stories, which like finding really interesting. It's like, yeah, I feel really good about it.
And the second workshop, we will be building the masks. Third workshop, all the participants will get to see their mask, meet their mask, and actually go through some embodiment exercises in terms of how does it feel when that person puts that mask on. And then we'll, you know, continue exploring how does that person want to be seen, where do they want to be photographed, and how does that relate to their story, which we'll be developing throughout those workshops.
It's kind of like interesting, even like when we talked about being photographed in this space, yeah. that like this is a space you don't necessarily want to be.
Yeah.
So kind of being able to be playful in this space, mm-hmm. or even just interpret their space in a different way than yeah. you see it day to day.
If I could say one thing to these individuals and to the general public about what these masks are, what these faces are, public art doesn't have to be something that everyone likes either. I think that that's okay. But if you remain curious about it and in a state of wanting to ask questions, I think that that just creates really good and meaningful conversation.